Gary, I would say that last 5 minutes kind of sums up the way things are going for Queens just now.
Yeah, it's unbelievable how we've not managed to score and score today, never mind just the last 5 minutes. But the last 5 minutes, yeah, probably what I spoke to the players about, that one of the three chances had, to be fair, I think Lyndon's hit the target and the goal, and they've cleared it off the line. Andy's got to hit the target or score, and Kai's then got to score for 2 or 3 yards out with a header. And but when you're missing chances like that, you're not going to win games or get points on the board. So the lads are aware that we need to start putting the ball in the back of the net. The effort, the commitment, everything that we've spoke about was there again today. But what's slightly frustrating is, if you look at the game, Dunfermline probably got on top for maybe 15 or 20 minutes in the second half, and they scored when they were on top. We've had various stages through the 90 minutes, whether it was at the start, at the first 15 or 20, or the last 5 or 10, when we're on top and we're not scoring. So it's when the opposition, you know, if you had said to me coming to the form team in the league that they'll only really be on top of you in the 15 or 20 minutes, in 90 minutes, I'd have took that today, and that's how the game was. Unfortunately for us, when they've been on top, they've managed to get a goal. And as you say, how we've not managed to score at the end, for when people watch the highlights, is beyond belief.
That's really kind of what's being punished at the moment.
Yeah, and it's now highlighting that we're over relying on Stephen, you know. And now Stephen himself's going through a wee barren spell, which he does. If you look at Stephen's Queen of the South career, he goes in spells like that, where he goes 5 or 6 without scoring, and then he goes 8 or 9 scoring, and then there's 3 or 4, and then he's 9 or 10 scoring. So, and at this moment in time, we need to step up and help him and help the team. And I feel for him, because it's very hard to stand here and criticise when I don't think I have criticised them the last 5 or 6 games that we've lost, because they don't really deserve it. Their performance levels, their commitment, their energy levels have all been really, really good over this period of time, and we've played well in nearly all the games. And for us to come away for that return, it's difficult, you know. It is difficult. It's difficult for the players, it's difficult for me, but that is football. A month ago, we're sitting fourth, we're getting awards, and then you lose 6 games and you're now looking over your shoulder and you know that you've got to get a win for somewhere. And unfortunately, that is football. It can be the best game in the world and it can be the cruelest game in the world. And right now, for the players, it's been really, really cruel for them. And for myself, you know, I keep referring to the players, but it's not easy for us as well. You know, we take it home with us, me and Doogie and the rest of the staff. But again, it falls on my shoulders and I'm the one that needs to get us a result for somewhere. But in terms of what, I can't actually ask for the players to give me any more, apart from scoring some of the chances that we're creating.
It stays like this. I mean, anybody that's probably watched Queens, actually been at the games and watched them over the last 4 or 5 games, would say it's just exactly the same things are happening.
We need to score goals, and that's what it is. And there's an over-reliance on Stephen, and sometimes that's got us results on its own. And there's other times where we've maybe conceded a goal and we've scored like 2 or 3. But now, when you know, what is the last 4 games? We've lost by 1 goal, is it? Dundee United, a penalty. Aloe at the last minute, a counter-attack. A corner, 86 minutes there. And then, to be fair, I think it was James Craigan that scored the goal. Or whoever scored it, I actually thought it was a really good bit of play for him. He dragged it onto his left foot and put it into the bottom corner. I don't think there's anybody that I can actually blame for their goal. I actually thought it was a good play for the Dunfermline player.
It was Ryan Blair.
Ryan Blair, yeah. Well, I thought it was a good bit of play for him. But I'm more disappointed that we've not put, you know, the whole mindset of the players and the feel in the change room would have been different if one of the chances gone there. And you can't miss chances like that, Sandra. I'm not publicly trying to hang the 3 players out, but one of them's got to go in the net. We've had a shot for 7 yards or 8 yards, it's been cleared off the line. We're in on goal and we hit over the bar for 7 or 8 yards, and then we miss a header for inside the 6 yard box. One of them's got to go in, because if we don't take the chances, we can't pick up points. Now, I've said the exact same things to the players. It's, you know, you're praising them and you're trying to give them constructive criticism at the same time, but that's evident for them. One of the chances must go in. Put one of them in, we come away with a point, and we say, you know what, that's a good performance away to the form team in the league. We need to now go and build on that.
It just shows you how a run does change the league, because there's Dunfermline now 7 points clear.
Exactly, and 6 games ago they were 5 or 6 points behind us. But Sandra, one thing's for sure, and I'll tell you, I'll be here and I'll be trying to lift this club up the league. There's absolutely no danger of me walking away or anything like that because of the recent results. I've never caught anything in my life, and I will only be thinking about quitting. There's absolutely no negativity in my mind. This group of players, if they keep playing like that, I'll eventually get a goal, they'll get a break and they'll climb the league, I'm certain of that.
As you said on Tuesday night, just one result can turn
one result, and it should have came today. And it should have came on Tuesday night, and it should have came last week. And that's the frustrating thing, because the performances are there. No team's turned us over. No team in the last this run, you go away thinking, wow, they're miles better than Queen of the South. Dundee United, as I say, the top team in the league. They're down to 10 men. We've got them paying back. Nobody's done it to us. So that actually adds to the frustration. But it's football. As long as I'm wanted here, I'll keep going to turn that around. And I want to be here, and I want to get this group of players where they should be at the end of the season.
Glad to see the back of this quarter.
Listen, it started really well. I think we've got 7 points for the first three games, and then we've not picked up. So that's what I've said to the players. We've got a lot of players in there. They've been missing training all week. They're putting their bodies on the line. We need to give them a couple of days, and then everybody needs to come back with 9 games to go and get as many points as we can. We have to just cross them off as they come. You know, it doesn't get any. There's no easy games in this league. You know, we start, I think it's Inverness next. So that's where we've got to start trying to get our season back on track. But you know, they're getting everything. The lads are on their feet in there. And they've all really, you know, this week, if you want, even I don't think we've had more than 12 players on the training pitch. So they're putting their bodies on the line. They're out there trying to play. And there's Big Darren again, another 80-85 minutes, 2 games in 4 days with somebody that's coming back for a cruciate. And he's been great, you know, so we all stick together in there. The fans, I thought, were excellent today. Even at the end, I went across and applauded them. And I seen them, that they were applauding the players, I think, to thank them for their efforts. And we're going to need that. The players need that support more than ever. This is when you need everybody to stick together. When the club's going through a sticky spell, as we're just now, it's vitally important that everybody sticks together. Nobody turns on each other. And that one result can change your season.
Did you say you want it to start on Saturday?
ASAP, and we need it to start ASAP. And as I say, the players will have a day or two off and they'll get recovered like they always would after we've had 3 games in a week, and we'll go again. You know, it'll probably be the same. Josh is probably another couple of weeks away. Nicky maybe longer than that. So it is what it is. And these players will get my full support because they're giving me their full support on the pitch. And I can't ask any more. The luck. And it's not just due to bad luck, but I've never seen anything like it in a run of 6 games in a row. Even all these ones that are falling, nothing's falling to us, but you just have to ride it, you have to be positive, and you have to come out the other end.
Inverness, as you say, up next. It's games like Inverness where Queens have done really well.
Well, even Dunfermline, you know, it's. I think we've played each other 3 times this season. It's one apiece and a draw. There's only been 2 goals scored in the 3 games. There's nothing between. I think if you, the Dunfermline in general, we. Our head-to-head since I've been at the club, it's probably maybe 3 wins apiece and 4 draws. So, but that's right, you know. Again, today we raised our game. We were good, but we've conceded a goal when Dunfermline's had that 10 or 15 minutes on top, and that's a disappointing thing.